days, which is Kirkus on Fire, with a new recipe. Very easy recipe, very, not easy, but I mean easy to make, very tasty to eat. So it's gonna be burgers today. Again, not very typical, maybe like you guys get used to, with little changes and all. So I'm gonna show you everything, how it will be, okay? So for today's dish, we ask our butcher to mince us 1.7 kilogram of beef, and I've got 450 grams of pork. That's already not something, you know, we usually, you guys get used to probably do it only with the beef, but I like the texture flavor of pork. So right, we've got meat, so let's put first of all spices here, okay? I've got black pepper, like I said, nothing really difficult. Last week we had a little bit of extras, maybe, you know, parts were harder to find, but this week is going to be more simple. Couple teaspoons of salt, okay? Right, with dried basil as well, 2 teaspoons. Again, I start to save them how many teaspoons, but you will forgive me that, yeah? Okay, and this is the spice part. Then I've got 100 grams of butter. This is gonna bring things much juicier. Okay, try to use it in room temperature. It will be easier for you to mix it all up. Okay, now, oh my God, I need to get my garlic thing. Okay, so we got about 1 small bulb of garlic, that sort of size. That's why I will put maybe not full, but nearly whole in. Okay. Right, so this is it, maybe a couple more. Okay, so now we're gonna have to cut the onion as well, you know, just to I'm gonna cut some onion, and we have to put some eggs as well, but I forgot to bring them out of the fridge. Right, that's again, I'm gonna put only maybe smaller half of it because it's a quite big onions I've got. Okay, so it's nice to have it in really, here we go, we got onions, eggs. Slide in. Right, so try to cut in a smaller bits, you know, you don't want to have them too big. This is our onion, guys. Again, a lot of deals here today. This is honestly, this is really strong onion. Good. So that's about it, guys. Now, no, not it. We've almost forgot the eggs again. We need an egg. One, yeah. It cannot be only one egg. Normally, it's always 2 eggs, yeah? No, I'm just joking, but 2 eggs, yeah? For that amount of meat, to keep them all nice and together. So here we go. Now, I'm gonna disconnect and I'm gonna mix it all out, okay? Almost forgot, because when you're about to finish, you see, we've still got a big bits of butter that should be all squeezed into the meat, you know. So we got smoked paprika. Okay, this is when it's gonna be, when you're gonna bite your burger, it's gonna give them kind of red juices, you know. Looks and tastes really good. Okay, guys, yeah, so we got meat prepared, mixed up and everything. I brought some mozzarella cheese, but I tried before to do with the grated one. It's more difficult, you know, because if you want to have it whole, like tangy cheese, or not tangy, how to call it, when you cut in half and it's all melting, you know. So it's better to have it in a one piece, you know what I mean? I couldn't get in one piece, I had sliced, but sliced like this, so I just cut them in the cubes. And I'm gonna show what to do next. Right, for the for the make a burger actual, you know, of course you can do hand with your hand, you can also use the, like a press thing to press it out, or I use them little friends now, they're very popular, you know, it costs really cheap and really easy to make, it looks really nice and also. We need to take some baking paper, okay, if you want to keep them not, you know, stick together. So take your, I don't know, I've got one of them, that's going to be quite big burger, but because I've got a mozzarella inside, so it can be, you know, bigger. Then take a simple brush, you know, with the vegetable oil, cheap as you can, and brush it inside of your, how to call it, it's a form or, you know, burger, you know, the burger press. Yeah, it's going to help you to remove it easily. Then, actually, sorry. Yeah. Then you have to take obviously some of your minced meat. I know you can take with your hands like that, but let's do it like that. Put in your burger press. Okay. Now I've got like a press bit as well. Put some oil on it to prevent to stick things. Coughing. Okay, so now we just press it a little bit everything. Here we go. If you can see it, we got that. We got like halfway in. Then I take the smaller form again. Yeah, butter on it. Butter, God's sake, oil. Sorry guys. I'm still shy a little bit. Okay, so. Then press in the center, press out the hole, if you know what I mean. Yeah. It's not always happening. Okay. Well, we got like a hole in it. If you can see it, I don't know. You can, I guess. Then put your cheese like in there. Mozzarella in like this, okay, and then cover everything with another spoon of meat. Like I said, they're gonna be big ones, that's a big boys, easy one per person, and I think you find you're not gonna ask for more unless you're my size, so maybe two, but normal I think it's enough for one. Okay, anyway. Okay, just cover to the top. Okay, and then let's get back to our press again. And press it, nice. Okay, all that extra, put it back to your hole. And let's have a look what we got. Okay, hang on, here. Okay, are we ready guys? Jesus, I've got another camera now, so I'm a bit losing where to watch. I'm apologize, yeah, but look what we got. We're gonna put it this way around, press it all out. Yeah, and then this is our burger, number one. Look at that, like in the shop, isn't it? Big, like I said, but you're gonna cook, it's gonna get a little bit slimmer, but yeah, this is our burger. So I'm gonna do a few more and then meet you, not sure where yet. I hope outside, the dream is outside, but weather is, it's not bad today, so fingers crossed. Okay guys, now we're gonna show you a quick recipe of coleslaw, tricky one. So like always, carrots, yeah. Cut the ends. Yeah, clean your carrots. But yeah, I mean, coleslaw, guys, you got loads of varieties, or how to say, types of it, you know, some of it makes with the, I don't know, we will make actually with the chili peppers, so, but jalapenos, with cheese, with all sorts of herbs, different colors, you know, and, you know, just, the way you like it. I'm gonna show you what we eat, you know, what sort of we like, but honestly, it's the quickest and best probably side for your any sort of barbecue meat what you got. I don't know, it's any type. So, carrot ready. Okay. So now, we've got only a few bits left. A little bit more than a few, but it's not many. Right. Okay. Now, red onion. But we have to cut in a nice and thin slices here. Now we've got of course cabbage. You can use red or white, up to you guys. Right, first of all, cut out that triangle thing. How to stalk? It's got a name of it in English, but you know what I mean, what holds all the leaves. So you cut that thing out. And again, try in really, really thin pieces, you know? So normally we do like this as well, but I will do again. Oh, that's what we got, guys, yeah? Like all coleslaw, got onion, cabbage, and carrot, yeah? And now let's open up our imagination. So we're gonna put some chili pepper, but again, no for seeds, because the lady behind that camera is so no. Okay, and again, nice thin slices. Actually, I think I'm gonna do it in a little cube. It will be, even if it will be some part spicier, it's not gonna kill her. Okay. So. Right, got chili. Now let's get some garlic. Not too much, just to give some sort of flavor, you know. Hang on, maybe this way. Not too much stuff on the table. Again, try to do it in a small bit, you know, small as you can. We could crush it at all, but I just washed my crushing and I don't want to wash it again. Sometimes it takes longer to wash it than you know, easier to cut it like that. Just chop it quickly. Chuk. This is garlic. Okay. Ooh, I just have to watch out for them seeds. Right. We got the what? Extra virgin olive oil. Ah, oh, that sound is gone just a little bit. Okay, then half of a lemon, not full, just a half. Okay. Okay. Watch out for them seeds, guys. Yeah, one of them actually fell in. Okay, yeah, right, black pepper, that's up to your flavor, yeah, salt, okay, and where is my things, just here, okay, I've got a mustard, and I've got mayonnaise, this, and mayo. just one more thing. We're gonna add on some fresh herbs. That's a deal, guys, yeah? That's all what you need. Just mix it all out. Give a go, I mean, give a try about salt. Sometimes we add on a little bit sugar as well, you know, but it depends how much kick your lemon, you know. Brown sugar. Just to balance flavors. Wow, very good. So, that's a quick recipe for you guys for our coleslaw. Okay, so we got our burgers, we got our coleslaw on the side. So now I'm gonna show you very nice and secret one. Burger sauce. It's again easy to make, very easy ingredients. So stay with me. So what we're gonna need, red onion in, okay? Some garlic, 4 cloves, maybe 5. Gherkins, I've got sliced, but if you don't have sliced, any will do. Okay, and I've got a little bit of them juices from gherkins, you know, that pickle juices, okay? Now, we've got some sugar, brown sugar, I should say. I've got mixed up half a little spoon of chili powder and half chili spoon of smoked paprika, okay? Then black pepper, just a pinch, okay? And of course, salt. So this is just a, give a little start, okay? So we've done for a start a little bit, okay? Everything is smoked up, cut up, or how to say, everything blended. Is blended a little bit. Still big bits, but okay. Previous, I will leave you a link below. I've done fantastic sauce of ajika. So if you don't, if you not bother to cook ajika, double up with the ketchup, okay? Because I will use half ajika, half ketchup. So then I got mayonnaise, ketchup, and a little bit of tomato paste, okay? Okay, that's it. Back on, and back to noisy part. Yep, okay, so we add on some parsley, just to make things greener. Okay, last blend and that's it. Your sauce is ready. Okay, enough of noisy part. That's what we have to do before we say that it's definitely good and all done. Let's give it a go. You know what? That's up, kicking. And I would add on a little bit more sugar because I think it's a bit sour. Okay, so I will have to put on the noisy part again for a minute. So we're back from that noisy part. Let's give a little try again. That's perfect, guys, that's it. It's a bit spicy, but she will survive this time, I think. Anyway, we have to have some little jar. Not jar, how to call it? Aladdin light? Saucer. Looks like Aladdin, yeah. Anyway, okay, so hang on. This. Whoa. It's a little bit more than that. This is my burger sauce. We had a beautiful start of the day, and now look what we got. As usual, guys, half of it is good, but another half in the rain. So we chose to cook in a gas grill. outside because typical, isn't it, to start to rain properly, but we managed to do three burgers for now. Toast the buns, yeah. So it's all ready to go anyway. So okay guys, I will start from my lovely magic sauce. Yeah, at the bottom, this is what I do. Okay. Okay, so now let's try to take it. Look at them big boys. Okay, but probably even I won't fit home. I mean, two of them I said before, but it's no chance. Okay. Right, we're back with the cheese, okay? We use Edam cheese. Mozzarella is inside. Outside is Edam. So, I don't know, it's gonna be taste anyway. Right, okay. So, some gherkins. Okay, and this is the one. Red onion, okay. I'll put some white onion as well. It depends what you like. I've got both, but right. And tomato, of course. Okay. Of course, more of my magic sauce. I can hear Charlie. He can smell it as well. Okay. Just have to close that game. What do you think about them three brothers, huh? Okay, so one of them we put straight to our photo place, okay? And now I have to show you what how it's gonna look like, isn't it? Showtime. Let's get another little plate. I don't know, I didn't try, and I hope inside it's all nice and melted. Right, so we're ready. Okay, so let's try. Okay, are we ready, guys? Let's see. I swear, it's first burger. Look at this. Okay, you see the score? I'm gonna show you from our camera because that's what we talk about, guys. Cheesy burgers. Okay, so now I have to try. That's gonna be messy when I can see because it's massive. But yeah, it's cooked, fully cooked. Everything is awesome. Going off, man. Guys, it's tasty, it's nice. I have to tell you, thank you so much for watching us. Wow, I have to finish it. Thank you very much for watching us. It's honestly, I want to finish as soon as possible to eat that. So please like, subscribe, comment, give us any you know of your attention. We're gonna do more. We've got big plans, you know, in the future, but you know, stay with us and you will see it all. Thank you so much and see you next time. Bye-bye. Here we go. We got the onions. Straight from nowhere. Thank you, operator. Thank you.
Eggs.
Oh my god. Voila. Here we go. This is our eggs, yeah? Thank you for my operator.